Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. So this question belongs to GATE CSE 2018, guys. Okay, so let G be a simple undirected graph. Okay, so let us start drawing the graph, guys. A, B, C, D. Okay, so let me connect it in this way. Okay,
yes.
Okay, so it is a graph, right?
Yes.
Okay, so let TD be the depth first search of the graph. Okay, so for this, we are drawing a TD, that is nothing but a depth first search, guys. Okay, so if I start at A, so where can I go? To B, I can go. Similarly, from B, I can go to D, and from D, I can go to C. Okay, so this is the depth first search. Okay, and let TB be the breadth first search. Okay, so again, we are having a TB also. That is nothing but a breadth first search. So from A, we will go to B, and from A, you will go to C. After that, the next possibility is from C, you will go to D. Got it? Yes. So now we drawn the original graph, the depth first search, the breadth first search. So the first three statements are done. Okay. So now the question is, no edge of graph G. So this is our graph, guys. Graph G cross edge with respect to TD. Okay. So it is a comparison between our graph and TD. So what exactly is this cross edge, guys? So a cross edge in graph G is between two nodes, neither of which is an ancestor, okay, of another in the TD. Okay, so I think we should be clear with the concept of ancestor, guys. So just give me a second. Okay, so I have just cross-checked the word ancestor, guys. So basically in a tree, ancestor is nothing but if you are checking for a C, the ancestor is a D, and for D the ancestor is a B, and for B the ancestor is A. So basically the parents are nothing but our ancestors, guys. So how we say in our family tree, so in the same way here also. So I was having a doubt, so that's the reason why I had just confirmed it, because I don't want to give wrong information in the videos. Okay,
yes.
Okay, so now let us go to the statement one again. So no edge of G, okay, is a crossover with respect to TD. Okay, so is that true, guys? So is there any edge with the exact crossover? A crossover in G is between two nodes, neither of which is an ancestor of other in TD. Okay, so I think this statement is a bit confusing, right? So let us understand it again. A cross edge in G, okay, is between two nodes. Okay, so it is between two nodes, neither of which is an ancestor of other in TD. Okay, but I think there are some edges in that way, right? So if you observe here carefully, so here C's ancestor, okay,
so now I'm getting the idea.
Okay, so if you observe here, who are the ancestors in this, guys? So can we find the ancestors in trees, guys? Sorry, in graphs. So I think we cannot find, okay, in any two nodes, neither of which is an ancestor in D. Okay, so if you take any two nodes, okay, so they should not be ancestors in this, guys. So if you observe here carefully, so what are the ancestors of C? So B, D and A, everyone is ancestor of C. Similarly, who is the ancestor of D? Those are nothing but B and A. So basically, I think this option should be correct, right? So number of no edge of G is a crossover edge with respect to TD. So basically no edge. So basically here we are having 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, right? So here we are having 5 edges, among which 3 edges are here. Okay, but if you observe carefully, who is the ancestor of C, guys? If you assume this as a tree, okay? Yes, so the ancestor of C will be A, right? Yes, so what will be the ancestor of B? So it will be A. What will be the ancestor of D? It will be B and C. So basically, if you observe, two of them have been removed, right?
Yes.
So I think A should be correct. So anyway, let us check through the next option also. So for every edge U, V of G, if U is at a depth I, that is nothing but 1, and 5, and V is at a depth, and V is at a depth J, so this is I and this is J, in a TB, then I minus J is equals to 1. So they are saying that at any point we take. Okay, so I think we can just prove this it is false, guys. So we can sure probably that 2 is false. Okay, so let us try. So let us take this as a, so in the graph we need to take, so let us take this as U, and this as a v, guys. So I'll be taking the root node itself as a v. Okay, yes. So now for every edge u comma v, okay, if u is at a depth I, so what is the depth, guys? So its depth is a 2, and v is at a depth 0. So where is the depth v, guys? So v is at a depth 0. So the difference between them, so I minus j is equals to 1, they are saying, but we got 2 here. Hence this option is absolutely wrong. So indirectly I can say, so option B is wrong and option C is wrong. So the answer might be in between option A or D. Okay, so I'm not getting clear idea about this cross edges, guys. I'm just a bit skeptical about it. So no edge. Okay, so I'll be trying for 1 or 2 minutes. If I'm not able to get it, I'll be just giving you a confirmation. Okay, yes. So no edge of G is a cross edge with respect to TD. Okay, so a cross edge in G is between two nodes, neither of which is an ancestor. Okay, so you need to select those two edges which are not ancestors. Okay, so basically, are these two ancestors, guys? No. Yes, yes. So these two are not ancestors. So few might be saying that those are ancestors, right? But these two are like this, guys. Okay, so let me draw for some other graph better. Okay, so I'll be drawing a tree only directly. Okay, so in this tree it will be easy, right? So assume that this is our graph. So basically every tree is a graph, right? Yes. So let us assume this one, in this only direct. Okay, yes. So a cross edge G is between two nodes, neither of which is an ancestor. So basically in G you need to select any two nodes. Okay, so at that time, so these two will not have an edge in the graph also. Okay, so now it makes sense. Yes, this will be absolutely correct, guys. So assume that this is our graph as well as a tree, TD. Okay, so both of them will be the same, right? Yes, even TB will also be the same because there is no extra edge, right? Yes, so here if there is no edge G in is crossover in TD, so in both the things it will be the same, right? So that is the reason why I think option A should be correct, guys. Okay. Yes. So if you did not got a clear idea, so please watch some other video, guys, because I'm not getting that much clear idea about crossover, but mostly I think the crossover means, so there is an edge between them. So one of both of them should be ancestors. So if both of them are ancestors, then it is called as crossover. Okay. That's what I'm getting from this sentence. Okay. Yes. So I think option A should be the correct answer. Okay. Yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea on this. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Okay. Yes. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.